Hello, everybody, what's going on? This is Will here, and we're back with another episode of Banjo-Kazooie. In the last episode, we finished up Click Clock Wood, so why the hell am I here? Well, turns out you actually have to be the bee to, get that last witch switch jiggy, so... Whoa, narrowly escaped that bird there. Alright. So apparently what happens is, what you can do is you can leave the spring door as the bee. And you can walk around, like, the main area and stuff, like, you know, that's all kind of cool and everything, I guess. I wonder if there's anything among the branches, anything kind of cool along here? I mean, you can walk along it, but it doesn't really look like there's anything. That's disappointing. Anyway, so what happens is, you can walk out here as the bee, but if you try to enter any other season, you get turned back into, the bear and the bird. What you can actually do, though, is you can leave the physical world as the bee, and you can actually just fly up on here and just fly your way up here, so you don't need a flight pad, although you did need to use flight. So, boom, look at that, 10 jiggies in Gruntilda's lair. Oh man, congratulations Banjo, you are the president of Grunty's lair, you have taken over the witch's hideout. And we have all 100 jiggies, which is friggin' amazing. I've never done that before in Banjo-Kazooie. In Banjo-Kazooie or Banjo-Tooie. Certainly not Banjo-Tooie. But, I want that gold feather. I want that feather of gold. I want it really bad. And I'm trying to get it, and it's not working. And, whatever. I'll just leave it be. Alright, so what I want to do now is... Yeah, I want to turn back into the bear and bird. Because now, what we've got to do is, pick up a couple things that we're able to get, as cheats. They're not necessarily cheats, because they do give them, like, the game gives them to you, explicitly through the game. But, they're still kind of cheats. Because they, like, upgrade your stuff. I wouldn't even call them cheats. They're more like upgrades, I think, personally. But, let's start with the first one. We're finally gonna go- Oh my god. Just get in Ding Pot. Just get in the Ding Pot. There we go. What we're gonna do is first we're gonna go to, Bubble Gloop Swamp. And, from there we're finally gonna do that thing in the Freeze Easy Peak painting room. Picture room, not painting. Where you have to, like, smash the ice and then go in as a crocodile and everything. We're gonna get that done right now, and, what we're gonna do is, it's going to take us to this special character that it lets you do cheats. He'll unlock 3 of them for you if you can find them 3 times throughout the lair. So we're gonna start with the first one, and then we're gonna do the second one, and then we're gonna do the third one. And then we're gonna punch in the cheats. So this is sort of like an extras episode just to do some last minute tidying up and everything. Then in the next episode, that's when we're finally gonna do some actual, like, you know, progression in the game. But, we've been doing nothing but progression since the start of the LP, so I hope you guys don't mind, you know, a bit of cleanup and screwing around. So, I don't know if I'm really gonna do much cutting here, but, I think it's more of just, like, a little backtracking trip, you know? Just getting to see the old levels and stuff again. Bubble Gloop Swamp is so cool. Love the music. It's just, oh my god, it's so bouncy and cool. I don't know. Not really what you'd expect for, like, a swamp level. You'd expect more of a murky, scary-sounding music, really. But, anyway, we have to turn to the oh, wait, no we don't. No we don't. Okay, well now I'm gonna do some cutting, because I forgot that I have to go and freaking break the ice in the... picture room first, so I'll go do that, then come back as the crocodile. Alright, so we're here at Mumbo's hut. Wake up, Mumbo! We need your help, buddy. Oh, I'm sorry, man. I didn't mean to claw at you like that. Alright, let's go. So now we're gonna turn into the crocodile. Now that I've actually opened up the little ice pathway, in the same session of the game, it doesn't stay broken, which is something that I didn't, take into account the last time I attempted doing this. But now that we're doing some cleanup, before the end of the game, I mean, like, we may as well. So, just gonna get going here. So, what happened in the world of Will in the past couple days? I don't even know. When was the last time I even recorded something? I know I just started recording. Yesterday. Was it yesterday or Friday? No, Friday. Friday, I fell asleep. Friday, when I got home from school, I was just so tired that I just fell asleep and I had a headache and everything. So it must have been Saturday. Yesterday, then. I did recording for Wind Waker. I did all of Dragon Roost Cavern. Yeah, that's what I did. You guys haven't even seen any of those episodes yet by the time you see this. You would have. You would have seen the start of it, the first of three. And now I just gave away how many parts long it is. Three. Ugh, I'm so good at this. But anyway, that's what I did Saturday. Did anything else really notable happen on Saturday? Not really, I don't think. I got some stuff confirmed for my partnership thing. I don't know, there's like some settings thing where it was like, YouTube was telling me to do this like confirmation thing or like verification thing through like text messages or like phone calls or whatever, so I was like, okay, whatever. So I did that and it didn't do anything. I got official live streaming confirmed for my channel, so that's kind of cool. Not sure what I'm going to do with that, but that's kind of cool. I will suspend my current conversation to do this. Cheato, the spellbook you have found. Magic cheats I have for you. Hey, book brain! What did you say? You better not give my spells away! Which lost book finders Bear and Bird are? Spell something. We sure do, bag lady! Come on, book boy! Give us the spells! Alright. Only one spell Cheato can tell. Enter the code Blue Eggs on Sandcastle Floor in Treasure Trove Cove World. Help you at will. Thanks, Mr. Cheato! Hidden in lair, other spell books are. Find them, should you. Okay. Well, so that's really our task, and what it does is, like, he calls them cheats, but really you wouldn't know to punch in these cheats at the time of your first trip to Treasure Trove Cove, right? But really, the thing is that it kind of ruins the whole illusion of it all, because as soon as you get the first code, being blue eggs, like, people are going to know to try red feathers and gold feathers, you know? So it's like, why bother locking up the other two? I don't know. I mean, it obviously is just a formality to make the whole idea of these little side things feel complete. Like, it'd be dumb if they just gave you the eggs cheat, but let all of the cheats be possible, but only let you know about the egg one? I don't know, it's just video game thing, I guess. Whatever. It works. So anyway, I got live... friggin' Gruntling. Get out of here. So anyway, I got live streaming done, so I don't know what that means. It would be cool to, like, do some live streaming stuff, but I don't really know how I'd execute it, to be honest. I mean, I don't really have very good equipment for it. I don't have a sound mixer, and I don't really have any of that stuff to make a worthwhile live streaming thing. I don't know. It would be kind of cool though, because it'd just be something new to try. And I do want to try a lot of new things with my channel this year. Like, whether I got the partnership or not, that was kind of something that I wanted to get done. Cut off Grunty's speech right there. Whoopsie. we're going to Mad Monster Mansion next. But I don't know. Live streaming would be fun. I want to try and do more co-op stuff. I really do. I really like to do a lot more games that are, like, two-player that I can do with people. I don't know. It'd be really fun. But I don't really know who'd want to, like, do stuff with me. I'm sure Jared wouldn't mind doing, like, co-op, Let's Plays. Oh, by the way, jeez, I just wanted to get the camera oriented behind Banjo. I'm not done with Pokemon Mystery Universe. I'm sure that there are so many people that probably wondered why that one just sort of fell off by the wayside there. But Pokemon Mystery Universe is not done. I do have I have intentions of wanting to finish it, but like I don't know. I don't know how Jordan and Jared are feeling about finishing it. I do believe it was one of us, it might have been me, but I know that one of us mentioned a possible goal of ending the LP when we've evolved our Pokemon. Because by then, like, I mean, like, we would have raised our levels up significantly. We would have, like, fought a lot of different Pokemon, would have explored a lot of the game by the time that happens. Because there is, like, a specific, like, really weird... Where am I trying to go? I'm going to Mumbo's hut, right. There is a very specific process to doing all that, so... I don't know. I mean, I think that's a good ending point, but I guess it's just what... It's more Jordan and Jared's call. I'm all for it if they want to keep doing it. And who knows, like, that might be a good time to... introduce the live streaming, maybe. Because instead of, like, recording it all over the Skype and everything, like... Recording it... So instead of having, like, the recording software taking up all my memory, I just have Wirecast in the background. And then, like, I don't know. Post down in the comments if you have any ideas. I'd really like to try some live streaming stuff. More notably, like, not just to bring, like, variety to the channel, but to, like, have a better chance at doing, like, some co-op stuff with people. Or, like, even just to, like, have, like, a more of a, I don't want to say less structured, because my videos in general are already pretty unstructured, but, maybe for, like, a more, like, casual play, style of video, rather than, like, doing an LP with completion in mind, making sure that I, like, hit all the benchmarks, like, you know, just something, like, casual. Something, like, just for fun. I don't know. It all depends on what you guys wanted, I guess, because, you know, as long as I'm playing a game, I mean, I'm having a good time. Having a great time walking along this zigzaggy path, but I don't know, like, with Jordan and Jared, that'd be kind of fun. Maybe do something with Kenzie, because she's at my house regularly. I don't know. I've always had ideas of, well, there's Cheato again. Cheato, Bear, and Bird have found once more another spell they get. If one more page I see you turn, then Grunty shall Cheato burn. Whoa. Wait, what? Nasty witch is, and I shall tell, enter Red Feathers and Sandcastle Floor and Treasure Trove Cove. Alright. Many tricks are up my sleeve. To save yourself, you'd better leave. Oh, well. I'm leaving. The pathway is getting progressively smaller. Alright, so anyway. Now I need to get back across this without dying. I just died. Good. Well, I got the cheat anyway, so I guess it doesn't really matter. I can just walk off to the side here and freaking keep walking until my magic wears off. But yeah, I don't know. Like, I don't know, like, how many of my friends would like to co-op with me. I don't know. It would be really fun to do, though. Like, it'd be so much fun. Like, even just kind of, like, reach out on a tangent and just, like, invite more people on to my videos, like, that, like, I normally wouldn't think of right off the bat. Like, Kenzie would be one of those people, because I know that Kenzie likes playing games, but I just don't know how she'd feel about, like, a co-op kind of, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, with this whole, I don't know what I'm trying to say here. going towards the third cheat. This whole... I guess a devotion, kind of like devoted, like keep going till the end of the co-op play, I don't know. Or like, I don't know. It'd be kind of fun though, Now I just feel spacey because I'm thinking about it. Just, whatever, just sound down in the comments if you freaking want to see something. Because I don't know what I'm doing after Banjo-Kazooie. I have no idea. Really don't know. I've covered most of the games that I've wanted to cover since I started the channel, so now it's more about just cherry-picking some nice games. Alright. This is probably the hardest cheat to get. Whoa. Just because of how much you don't really expect this one. It's just, it's kind of random. You would not expect it. At all. Is this whole timer thing. I don't know, it just seems like it's added in for a gimmick. Because this doesn't really take you anywhere to progress in the game itself, but... It actually takes you up to a little alcove. There it is. There it is right there. Ooh, okay. Just barely met the time limit. And Cheato once again, third one. Bear and Bird getting good at finding Cheato. So another spell they shall have. That traitor book has pushed its luck! So in the burning fire I'll chuck! Oh, that is mean, man. Don't burn a book with googly eyes. Code you must enter on Sandcastle Floor in Treasure Trove Cove is Gold Feathers. Alright, cool. So, kind of a longer video. But, what I'll do is, I'll do a cut of me after I've punched in all these codes, and I'll show you guys the end result of what's really happened here with these cheats.